7 through 11. Psalm 19 says, "The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. The statutes of the Lord are righteous, rejoicing the heart. The commandments of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eyes. The fear of the Lord is clean, enduring forever. The judgments of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. More to be desired are they than gold, yea, even than much fine gold. Sweeter also than the honey and the honeycomb. Moreover, by them is thy saint warned, and in keeping of them there is great reward." Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we're here to give you thanks and glory. We need you today, Lord. We need you to be here. We need your Holy Spirit, Father. We open up to it. Hide this preacher behind the cross, and let it be you that is seen, and only you that is heard. And I give you all the thanks and glory because you're worthy. In Jesus' name we pray, and we say,
amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Today's title, True Prosperity. You may receive it. True prosperity. What is true prosperity? According to God, this is true prosperity. Right here in these verses, it says that the law of the Lord converts the soul. The testimonies of the Lord make the wise, make simple wise. The statutes of the Lord rejoices the heart. The commandments of the Lord enlightens your eyes. The fear of the Lord endures forever. The judgments of the Lord are righteous. Verse 10 says, "More to be desired are they than gold." Yeah, than much fine gold. Sweeter also than the honey and the honeycomb. Hallelujah. So the law, the testimonies, the statutes, the commandments, the judgments, all together are God's words. When it says testimony, judgment, precept, it means God's word. Amen? God says that to have this and to love this is true prosperity. Amen? True prosperity has nothing to do with your bank account. It has nothing to do with the type of house you live in or the type of car that you drive. Hallelujah. True prosperity doesn't come from your job. True prosperity doesn't come from your degrees. True prosperity doesn't come from your business deals. True prosperity comes from God. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us that the Word of God is valuable treasure and that it is to be desired more than fine gold. Hallelujah. For the believer, the treasures of prosperity are found in the Word of God. Hallelujah. That's right. You are called to live an abundant life. You are called to prosper. Hallelujah. Your prosperity is in this Word. Amen. Today. That's right. You cannot prosper without living or loving or treasuring the Word of God. Amen. Loving and treasuring His Word means obeying His Word. If you love it, you will treasure it and you will obey it. Hallelujah. Verse 11 says, "Moreover, by them is thy servant warned, and in keeping of them there is great reward." Hallelujah. There is treasure in the Word of God. There is great reward in obeying God's Word. Amen. Yeah. He says that in keeping of them, there is great reward. The word keeping in verse 11 here is taking heed of the Word, living out the Word, guarding the Word, and obeying the Word. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. So how can I truly prosper? How can I take heed of God's Word? How can I live it out? How can I keep it? How can I obey it? That's the question. So another question, how can I heed the Word? How can I live out the Word? And how can I obey the Word? What Psalm 119:10 tells us, it says, "With my whole heart have I sought thee. Oh, let me not wander from thy word." Hallelujah. This is how true prosperity comes. You seek God's word with all your heart, and you wander not from his word. Hallelujah. That's right. Here's where many have serious problems. Many seek God's word, but it's not wholehearted. Amen? It's half-hearted. And James says that a double-minded man will never truly prosper. James 1, 6 and 8 says, "For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea driven with the wind and tossed about. For let not that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways." So James says that you will never have true prosperity with half-hearted efforts or being double-minded. Amen? Double-minded people see two paths of prosperity. They see the worldly prosperity, and then they see godly prosperity. Worldly prosperity is all about the world's fortune and the treasures of the world. Earthly treasures. Cars, houses, boats, bank accounts, investments, bonds, stocks, real estate, pedigrees, fame, name, and power. Amen? Worldly prosperity, brothers and sisters, is not true prosperity. Amen. That's right. Worldly prosperity will fade. Godly prosperity endures forever. Amen. Hallelujah. That's right. Matthew 6, 19 says, "Lay up for yourself treasures. Lay not up for yourself treasures upon the earth, where moth and rust do corrupt, and where thieves break in through and steal. But lay up for yourself treasures in heaven, where neither moth, neither rust, nor do it corrupt, and where thieves do not break through, nor steal." Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. So true riches doesn't come from this world. True riches is not in this world. True riches come from treasuring the right things. True prosperity comes from valuing God's word. When you treasure it like more than silver and gold, true prosperity will come. Hallelujah. The law, the statutes, the commandments, the judgments of God are to be desired more than gold. He says, yeah, even more than fine gold. Amen. And he even says that it's sweeter than honey and sweeter than the honeycomb. Hallelujah. True prosperity comes from loving God's word. Hallelujah. And I'm not talking about getting prosperity through works. I'm not talking about prosperity comes through not sinning and giving up all you got. That's there, but that's not what I'm talking about today. Today I'm talking about treasuring God's word more than gold or silver. More than the prosperity of the world. Amen? That's right. I'm talking about digging into the word like you're digging in a gold mine. Amen. Amen. Cracking into the word like you're cracking into a diamond mine. Amen. If you knew that there was gold in that mine, you would dig. A lot of people got gold mines and they spend their whole life digging. Even a little bit comes out. They get a little bit, they keep digging. It takes them years breaking down, setting up, you know, explosions and getting in there. Amen. Working it. Well, this is like that. This is a gold mine. This is a treasure. And we got to dig and dig and dig and get those nuggets out. Get those precious stones out. Hallelujah. That's right. When you read this word and treasure what he says, that's when you begin to get the real gold, the real silver, and the real precious stones. Amen. That's right. Psalms 119:11 says, "Thy word have I hid in mine heart." Hallelujah. This psalmist says, "I have stored up your word I have hidden your word. I've saved up your word. I'm treasuring your word down deep in my heart. Amen. Brothers and sisters, God's word is more valuable than silver or gold. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Psalm 119:14 says, I have rejoiced in the way of thy testimonies as much as in all riches. Hallelujah. This psalm is new. The gold and the silver that's in here is worth more than anything this earth can have. Amen. That's right. He says in Psalm 119:72, the law of thy mouth is better unto me than thousands of. Again, in Psalm 119:127, therefore I love thy commandments above gold, yea, above fine gold. And my favorite, Psalm 119:162, I rejoice at thy word as one that findeth great spoil. Yeah. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. True prosperity is found in God's word. True riches are found right here in the word of God. True riches. Hallelujah. We need to take this word. We need to take these riches. We need to take this great spoil and conceal it as treasure down deep within us. Hallelujah. That's right. Hiding the word in our heart is not just taking one verse and keeping it on our mind and remembering that one verse. No, it's more like getting a mass of verses, a fortune of verses, amen, and storing them up and guarding them like if it was gold and silver, like Fort Knox. They got the gold and now they're protecting it because it's treasure. It's valuable. They can't just let anybody come and take it, amen. You guard it with your life. It's gold, it's treasure, it's jewels. Hallelujah. That's right, brothers and sisters. Treasuring God's word leads to a life of true prosperity. This book is a gold mine. It is a treasure chest. And it needs to be treated like it's treasure. Amen? That's right. If you knew that you had a gold mine in your yard, I guarantee you wouldn't leave apart from it more than a few hours, maybe to go eat, take a shower, sleep. If it was a true gold mine, you'd be there all day sitting on that gold mine, digging and digging and digging and digging. Well, this is what this is. It's a gold mine. The only time you'd be away from this is when you have to be, amen? Every other time, you're in it digging out gold. Like when you go to work, you know you're going to get paid, so you got to put in the 8 hours. Because you know that at the end of that 8 hours or the end of that 40-hour week, you're going to get a paycheck. Well, this is the same way. We dig into it and we'll one day get a paycheck from this. Amen? If your mind is right and you've got the right thing in mind, it will happen. My friend of mine at work, he goes, I'm going to prophesy to you. I'm going to prophesy to you a prophecy. If you work 8 hours a week, you will soon get money. Amen? And that's true with this. If you get in this and absorb it and hide it and treasure it like a treasure, you will see the prosperity of the Lord come upon you. Amen. It's just that simple. But the thing is, we want to do it our way. We want the treasure, but we don't want to dig it out. Amen? That's right, brothers and sisters. That's right. This book is a gold mine. And it needs to be treated like it's treasured. Too often we treasure the things of the world more than the things of God. We treat treasure like trash and trash like treasure. Amen? That's right. That's right. To have true prosperity, we must properly value the Word of God. It's gold. It's diamonds. It's silver. Hallelujah. That's right. We need to learn it, we need to study it, we need to memorize it, we need to apply it, and he says that we need to meditate on it. Psalm 119:15, I will meditate in thy precepts. Hallelujah, that's his word. The prosperity of the world says you will find delight in earthly wealth. But the Bible tells us that earthly wealth is empty, meaningless, void and vanity. Hallelujah. If you want to find true prosperity, you need to delight yourself in the Word of God. Hallelujah. Psalm 1, verse 2 and 3 says, but he whose delight is in the word of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night, he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of living water that bring forth fruit in season. His leaf shall not wither, and whatever he shall do will prosper. That's godly prosperity. He'll plant you next to living water where your tree's not going to wither. Anything you do is going to prosper. Amen? But it comes God's way, not our way. True prosperity comes when the Word of God is your delight. Is the Word of God your delight?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Don't answer, because I might have to call you a liar. Amen? Hallelujah to Jesus. That's right. He discovered that earthly treasure can be stolen, it could be destroyed, it could rust, but heavenly wealth is forever. Hallelujah. Whatever you get, another man can take. Whatever I get on my own, another person can steal it. Whatever I do on myself, whatever man gets, another man can take. But what God gives, no man can take. Amen. That's right. Somebody could cheat me out of my money. Somebody could steal my money. Somebody could con me into some investments that I shouldn't do. I mean, they could be stolen, took it, corroded, corrupt. The value of the dollar could drop today, and your dollar ain't worth nothing. But God's prosperity is forever. Amen. He says in Psalms 119:14, says, I have rejoiced in the way of thy testimonies as much as in all riches. I will meditate in thy precepts and have respect unto thy ways. I will delight myself in thy statutes. I will not forget thy word. You see how much value he puts on God's word? It is everything. God's word is everything. We don't mind wasting our health to go get money. We don't mind spending all day out in the sun and the heat, sweating from stuff we don't like to eat just to get that dollar. Amen. We wake up early, go to bed late, and we do it again day after day to get a few bucks from work. If we put that same effort in this, got up in the morning like it was a 9 to 5, and start digging into this word and get into it, imagine how much riches would come your way. The Bible says it, I believe it, and that's the way I'm preaching it. It says it right there, if I delight in his word, my leaf will never fade, and everything I touch will prosper. That's God's prosperity. That's true prosperity, amen? That's right, if you want to truly prosper, you must delight yourself in the word of God. Why does that seem so hard for us? Amen, I'm not telling you to go on a mission trip. I'm not telling you you have to go to church. You know, every time the door's open. I'm not telling you to stop sinning. I'm not telling you to change your evil ways. I'm telling you to delight yourself in the Word of God. Yeah. That's no work. Why is it becoming hard work to do? Just to open it up and just read it and say, Lord, speak to me. I need something. I need to hear from you. Lord, help me. Tell me where to go. Tell me where to read. And after I read it, say, Lord, now help me understand what I just read. Give me the wisdom to apply this word as you'd have me do it. Amen. And he will do it. Amen? Amen. He will do it, brothers and sisters. God wants you today to prosper in all areas. The Bible says that he wants to make you whole. Whole means complete, lacking nothing, owing nothing. To be whole means you're complete. Hallelujah. Deuteronomy 28 says that if you hearken diligently on the word of the Lord, that he will set you high. All blessings shall come upon thee. The Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, that you shall lend unto many and borrow from none, if you hearken diligently to the word of God. That means he doesn't want you to have any bills. He doesn't want you to have a mortgage. He wants you to have your house paid off. Your car paid off. Amen. Your loans paid off. He doesn't want you to have any bills. He wants to make you whole. Whole means you don't owe nothing. You lack nothing. You're not sick. You're not crippled. You're healthy. Your bank account's healthy. You don't owe any money to nobody. You don't need any more than God gives you. Like I said, He doesn't say you're going to be rich. He says you're going to be whole. Whole is being rich. Amen. When you don't need nothing, you don't lack, you don't owe. Hallelujah. That's right. He wants your mortgage paid. He wants your car bills paid. He wants the loan. He wants you to lend people money, but He doesn't want you to borrow money. That's the prosperity of the Lord. That's true prosperity. Hallelujah. That's right. The Lord wants to make you debt-free. House paid, car paid, loans paid. But it has to be His way. We have to do it His way. And His way is that we delight ourselves in the Word of God. Amen. That's right. If you're delighting yourself in the Word where it says He'll make a way where there is no way, just think about that one verse. And I start delighting in that. He'll make a way where there is no way. He'll make a way. And then I start believing the Word of God because I'm delighting in it. He'll make a way where there is no way. And I love what it says. I love the Word of God. And then I start to believe it. And then I start to speak it. And that's what makes the prosperity come. When I believe His Word. It all comes from me delighting in His Word and believing His Word and taking His Word serious like it's gold and I treasure it. What would happen? What happens is you start believing it. You start loving it. You treasure it. When you treasure something, you hold on to it, you hide it in your heart, you keep it, and then your faith will start working because now you love His Word, you're believing His Word, you're holding it, you're not letting it go, it's your life, it's your prosperity, and that right there will get you that prosperity that God wants for you, amen? That's how simple it is. But He wants you to be blessed, but He wants you to do it His way. His way is you love my word first. You love my word first and act like it's better than gold, sweeter than honey, sweeter than the honeycomb. Then you'll be ready. Then you'll be ready. But we want all gold. Man, if I win the lotto, I'll give that church down there $1 million. If you gave me $300,000, $300 million, I'll give it to you. See, we want God to show up first. We want God to give us the riches first. And then we might give Him some. God's not that way. God works the other way. You give me what's due to me first. And then, off of that, then your prosperity will come. Amen. But sometimes we want to go get it on our own. We can't wait on the Lord. We want to go do the deal. We want to go get the loan. We want to go have things that we can't afford. And God says, now you're in debt. Now you're in bondage. Now you're serving the enemy. Now you're all trapped up and chained up, strapped to that. But God says, when you do it my way, there will be no outstanding loans that you owe. Amen? There'll be no outstanding credit. There'll be no outstanding mortgage in God's true prosperity. Amen? God wants to make you whole this morning. He wants to give you the desires of your heart. But your desires has got to be number one first. The Word of God. We love God. He's first, of course. But if we want to hear from God, the way to get to God is through His Word. So if you love God, like we say we love God, then that means I want to talk to God. I want to be in a relationship with God. I want to have God as my friend and my master. The only way that's going to happen is through His Word. Amen. If I love God, I'm like, okay, I can't touch God. But I can get to Him through His Word. So if I love God, how do I get to God? Through the road He gave us. This is the road to God's prosperity. That's the road to God's goodness. That's the road to God's healing. That's the road to God. Everything God has for you is through that Word. But we gotta love it. We gotta treasure it. It's gotta be valuable. It's gotta mean something. Hallelujah. Let's stand and give God glory.